Power system design and analysis, in which we are going to discuss about neutral grounding. Or we can say first we start with only grounding part. What do you mean by grounding or earthing? Grounding means as we know that every machine or every system having metallic part. Some metallic part are the current carrying metallic part, some are the non-current carrying metallic part. So in the time when we talk about term grounding, it means to connect non-current carrying metallic parts to the ground, so that if any abnormal condition occurs, means if any live wire due to the insulation failure touches that non-current carrying metallic part, that leakage current should flow through ground. It should not harm a human body or apparatus. So what is grounding? Okay, this is a definition of grounding, to connect non-current carrying metallic part of a system or machine to the ground. That process is called as grounding. Okay, it is also known as earthing. So don't get confused with grounding and earthing in terms of electrical engineering. I'm not discussing about the term that belongs to electronic part. Now another term is, there are two kinds of earthing. One is equipment earthing, another is system earthing. There are two sections, equipment another is system grounding. Okay, so we will discuss them one by one with their importance, why grounding is required in the case of equipment and in the case of power systems. When we talk about system, is that means power system. Okay, so we are discussing for in the case of equipment earthing, first ungrounded system, okay? There are three kind of cases. One is ungrounded system, second is enclosure connected to neutral section, neutral wires, and third one is ground wire connected to the enclosure. Enclosure is the, basically what is enclosure? Enclosure is a non-current carrying metallic wire that is used to protect the device from the environmental conditions as well as in the case of motors, the magnetic poles are fixed with the enclosure, that is also known as yoke. Okay, so first we are taking ungrounded system. So just forget this part for a while. This is an ungrounded system that is getting supply from the 231 ppr supply. This equipment, what we can say, it is, I'm not mentioning model, it is equipment. This is the equipment that is working properly, but due to any reason, if insulation is failed and the live wire due to the insulation failure comes in contact with the enclosure, that is non-current carrying metallic part, then what will happen, the resistance between the live wire and the enclosure reduces to very low value. So now this enclosure will also be a current carrying part, or you can say it is also acting as a live part. If a human body touches this enclosure, since that human body is not having any kind of protection, definitely it is also comes in contact with the ground. So definitely this current now will choose the path through human body, because in this part, this equipment part is not connected with the enclosure of this equipment is not connected with the ground. So it can, the current is remain in the enclosure, it cannot move anywhere. So once a human body is touching this, it is getting the path through the human body, and so the current will follow, this linkage will follow this path, and the human being will get a big shock. Okay, it is represented as IL. I would represent it as IL because it is a linkage current due to the insulation failure in the network. So this is about the ungrounded system. In the second case, if enclosure is connected to the neutral wire, enclosure connected to neutral wire, So if in the second case, if the enclosure part is connected to the neutral wire and due to insulation failure, if live part of the equipment comes in contact with the enclosure, definitely current will come in, current will flow through the enclosure then this part, okay, and it will return to the neutral wire. This is your neutral wire, this is your phase, okay. So in that condition we can find out that the leakage current will catch the path through neutral and the human body will not come and come, will not get any kind of, if a human body, now in this condition if human body is touching the enclosure, it will not get any kind of shock, okay. So this is a protective scheme, that if the enclosure should be connected to the neutral wire. But there is one problem, is that if this switch is not placed in the phase, if it is connected in the neutral side, then there is a big problem. Problem is that now switch is open, but the current, since the live wire phase is giving the supply to the equipment, and due to insulation failure, enclosure is in contact with the live wire, and now the current should flow through this wire, but this path is not completed here. So this is an energized enclosure. What we can say, this is a live enclosure or energized enclosure. If a human being touch this, it will get shocked definitely. Reason being, in this condition now the leakage current will flow through this part, then this part. So if you are connecting enclosure with the neutral wire, that's quite safe. But it is dangerous if the switch is connected in the neutral wire side, because in this condition, though there is no supply, machine equipment is not working because path is not completed here. But directly phase wire is in contact with the equipment, and that non-working equipment, equipment enclosure having current in this part in his body. So suddenly if any person touches this part, it will get shocked. So by repeating this, it is not working, but we will get a shock. So we this is the this another case, and third one is grounded enclosure. Now look at this diagram. In this diagram, enclosure is connected with the ground wire and with ground. So if due to insulation failure, if live wire of the machine or equipment touches the enclosure, that current, leakage current, will take the path through ground and path will be completed like this one, because the resistance of ground, this path, is less than the human body resistance. Here RB is less than the arch, so definitely if human body touching this part, nothing will happen to human being, and because the current is taking the path through this ground terminal, because the resistance of ground is ground of resistance of ground is very less as compared to human body. So according to current equation, definitely most of the current will flow through. Now we are going to discuss about the system grounding. First, initially we discussed about the equipment grounding. Now we are discussing about the system grounding. Okay? So system grounding, why system grounding is required? System grounding means power system grounding. So if we take why this grounding is required, first we will discuss why the grounding is required in the power system. We are going to explain the causes. This is a general power system in which we are representing 11 kV line and one transformer whose primary is energized with 11 kV line and output is at 230 volt. Though they are not electrically connected, and here what we are representing that this system is ungrounded system. So there would be one capacitance, that is C1, that is between the primary and secondary winding, and another capacitance is C2, that is between the secondary winding or secondary side and fifth ground. Okay, due to that potential difference, some voltage would be there. So it will represent 500 volt due to that capacitance. Due to this C2, the voltage, the voltage field would be 500 volt nearby. In the second case, if anybody touches this part, if a human body shock. This is the first case in which nothing external load nahi happens. Only due to the capacitor effect, voltage is there, and when a person touching that, definitely path is completed and person is getting short. In the second case, it may happen by any reason if high voltage side is touching the low voltage side, then severe damage may occur. That may damage the equipment as well as that may damage the human being's life. Okay, so it can be represented like in the second case. So it can be, you know, it can be represented like that. Due to any reason, look at this 11K line is now touching the secondary side. So if anybody human body is touching this part, definitely will get shock of high voltage. But if this secondary side is connected to the ground like this, then what will happen? Now the additional current will take path to okay. Now what we need, if we are connecting this secondary side to the ground, then if a high voltage line is touching the low voltage side, this current will take this path and return to the neutral side.
You see, we can see this is phase which is neutral.
So these are the different cases through which we can motivate ourselves for the system grounding.